It's a very big universe I've created. That's all my job is to be the keeper of the flame.
When you think of George Lucas, you think of Star Wars. It seems impossible to sum up how good of a writer and filmmaker George is. But I'm going to try.
You will try.
Star Wars is like no other franchise. When creating a film that is sci-fi or takes place in an era where space battles are a common theme, George really made it seem not about the spaceships and the sound and visual effects. He made it seem about the story.
And it's all about family problems and that kind of, it's not about spaceships.
Anybody can create something that involves the stars and technology that is too far advanced for us humans today. However, a project, no matter how good it looks, will never be complete without a solid story. A story is the foundation of any movie. If you create a movie with great effects and a bad story, no matter how good it looks, the movie will still be bad. That is why having an amazing story is crucial for any success. Dialogue, visual effects, sound effects, and scenery is what I want you to picture as a nice house. The story is what we can visualize as the foundation of the house. The nice house cannot survive without the foundation, just like flashy scenes cannot survive without a quality story. When you look at the house, at first glance, it's just about the look of the house. However, once you take more time to look at the house, you notice the foundation. That is what keeps the house up. The foundation is a good story. When you create a good story and have effects, it becomes an amazing project. That's how we get to George Lucas. Creating an amazing story is George Lucas' speciality.
Chancellor Palpatine, Sith Lords are our speciality.
All I need is an idea.
Star Wars is well known in 2022. However, if you think about Star Wars universe, it's crazy different than how we live today. To that, you might say, well, yeah, because it's a movie, of course it's going to be different. But to those people, I want you to imagine George Lucas back in 1977 releasing Star Wars, wondering if people will enjoy this. Even though George Lucas got some ideas from Star Wars from other movies and books that already existed, you have to remember there was nothing like Star Wars back in 1977. Not only that, but all episodes 4, 5, and 6 were all different. Different planets, characters changing through each movie, and a different mood or vibe to each movie. The only thing connecting the movies was that it was a Star Wars movie, and Star Wars was a new idea. So you can see how many chances George Lucas took with his money and his career to do Star Wars. Hollywood did not like his script of A New Hope because it was like no other. Hollywood likes things that already work because they think that makes the most money. Clearly, they were wrong.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Try thinking of an idea you have for the Star Wars universe. Pretty easy, right? Now try writing it. Not so easy, is it? The world of Star Wars is so big and it has so many characters in each film. They are all real characters, and I'm going to explain why that's important soon. I can go on describing Lucas's expertise on Star Wars, but that's not going to help my claim of how he's the best. So I'm going to compare him to the writers of Disney Star Wars movies. And we will see how they compare. Lucas has many characters who follow along with Luke throughout the original trilogy. All of those characters change throughout the movies, some more than others. J.J. Abrams' characters were so poorly written that they had to sacrifice their own character to build up another.
What did you say?
Okay, let me put it like this. Han Solo follows Luke throughout the movies and learns that there's more to life than money and fancy ships. He learns to be a part of something bigger, like the Rebellion. JJ's character Finn is set up great. However, his character has no changes and is left to waste just to boost Rey. JJ was afraid more than anything. He was afraid of taking chances. So he built the character Finn just to push Rey's character. This was also done with Poe, Rose, and Luke. The difference between a good writer, George, is each character means something to the overall story. While JJ makes characters to help boost the main character and then sets them aside when he's done with them. Star Wars is timeless, and it always will be, and that's because of George Lucas. Disney sees what George has done, and they want that for their Star Wars. But the issue is, it's not their Star Wars. It's George Lucas's Star Wars. You cannot split them apart no matter how much you try. Disney should be looking at everything George did. Movies 1 through 6 are perfect. Star Wars, because they are different. People who didn't like The Phantom Menace thought it was so boring. However, they did not realize that there's never been a Star Wars movie that is similar to the previous. JJ had an open world, but he was afraid to do anything, so he tried what already worked. However, he didn't realize that what worked was creating a movie that was different from the last. George Lucas will always be a part of Star Wars. Whether you like it or not, he created the greatest franchise ever by taking chances. If you don't take chances, then it's not Star Wars. And Star Wars not really feeling like Star Wars is a common thing these last few years. It's time for someone with courage to write a Star Wars project. If you enjoyed this style of video on my channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and that like button to let me know you want more of these. I'm working on a few more now, and it would be great to see how you guys think of this. Thank you for watching, and there's many playlists on my channel if you click that, and you can stay up to date on everything, and hear some cool facts about Star Wars. So make sure to go do that as well. See ya.